axis has a movement called precession. Precession is a rotation of the axis around the perpendicular to the ecliptic, which completes along a very long period with respect to human life, about 26,000 years. Precession is of fundamental importance for archaeastronomy. In fact, although it has no effect on the apparent motions of the Sun, the Moon, and the planets, precession changes very slowly the declinations of all the stars. Therefore, taking precession into account is essential for a reconstruction of the night skies as ancient peoples saw them. To understand what happens, let us start from the North Celestial Pole. Since the Earth axis describes a circular cone, the pole moves along a circle. In a certain epoch, it may or may not pass near the position of a brilliant star. What we call the pole star today is actually the specific star close to which the North Pole is today. During the first half of the 3rd millennium BC, another star, Tuban of the constellation Draco, was the pole star. While in the period in between, no pole star existed at all. The North Celestial Pole was in a dark zone. By the way, the South Pole is always in a dark zone, as its path never intersects a brilliant star. Clearly, the declinations of all the stars are subject to this precessional shift. In particular, some constellations can be brought under the horizon by precession, thereby proving to be, in certain epochs, constantly invisible from a certain latitude, and eventually becoming visible again with the passing of time. One important example is the Cross Centaurus group, a prominent asterism of the southern hemisphere, which was still visible from the Mediterranean, although low on the southern horizon, up to the last millennium BC. As precession changes the declination of the stars over the centuries, one of its effects is that it changes the background to the stars where the sun rises on a fixed day of the solar year. In particular, of course, this occurs at the equinoxes. For instance, in the centuries around 1 AD, the winter solstice was moving from Capricorn to Sagittarius, and the spring equinox from Aries to Fishes. It is from the shift of the constellation housing the spring equinox that precession is also called precession of the equinoxes. However, this terminology can be misleading, so my advice is to avoid it. Due to precession, we need to reconstruct the ancient sky. How can we do that? The answer is given by mathematical astronomy, that is, the calculation needed to know the position of the celestial bodies in the past or in the future. Until the advent of personal computers, it was a tedious task due to the difficulties of performing long equations by hand. Fortunately, today, astronomical softwares do the job. An astronomy software, or digital planetarium, is an instrument which calculates and consequently simulates the appearance of the sky at any chosen time. Instead of projecting the sky on a dome, as in a real planetarium, it reproduces the sky as flat images on the computer screen. There are many good softwares of this kind, and some are completely free of use, like, for instance, Stellarium. They are very easy and amusing to use, and my advice is to start to enjoy them immediately.